Here looks like some of the big boys are getting the cuts, but the new folks not so much. They're still in the clear.
Well, you know, this has been a theme for so many years now, since the crisis, really. But of course, European banks followed a little later than U.S. banks. So you know, the last few years they've seen more job cuts as well as bonus cuts. So as Barclays, you know, this shows that this is, you know, very closely related to fewer people that they're hiring. They've closed down certain divisions in different products. They don't do them anymore. So, you know, they're shrinking from certain markets. So that means fewer people, and that's fewer bonuses.
Obviously, Yellman, this will not be happy news to the employees affected, but it doesn't go as far as some other banks. Deutsche Bank killing all bonuses in 2016. So compare and contrast the banks taking different approaches and what that might do to their business.
Yes, and you know, it's a great example. Deutsche Bank was so much harsher. It just came a few weeks ago, you know, the news that they are not paying any bonuses to anyone this year. You know, and that sounds scary. A lot of people probably are upset there. But, you know, Deutsche Bank is behind even other European banks. They have still not really reduced headcount. Barclays, Credit Suisse, UBS, they've all been cutting headcount over the last 3-4 years. So they're at a better place. They have built up capital better, faster, and they can handle sort of the lower revenue that's going on in those firms. But Deutsche is way behind, and they still
and
have
as
a lot
you
to
said,
go.
The U.S. banks sort of got out in front of this. How do they compare now, and what do we expect there?
I mean, you know, the death toll hasn't stopped. It's not over. There's still reduction. It's slowed down a lot, though. And for example, J.P. Morgan last year, their numbers were even up. So I mean, were those, you know, bank tellers or actually investment bankers at on the trading side? It's hard to tell. They don't give us a breakdown. But most likely, you know, some of the European bank U.S. banks that are doing stronger, they have stopped firing people, and they have actually managed to expand in some areas. J.P. Morgan has been gaining market share in fixed income, in equities, and everything. So the U.S. banks are doing better. So the troubles aren't as bad. Yet still, we haven't seen the end of sort of Wall Street job cuts even here.